Welcome back to Let's Play Castlevania Legacy of Darkness. Last time, we entered the clock tower. So it's time to start moving. Oh yeah. I kinda dislike the fact that this game and 64 opted for a more atmospheric soundtrack, you know. Can't help but to feel a little disappointed, especially after the complete and utter awesomeness that was the soundtrack of other Castlevanias. Oh. Okay, that kills you. That's a little merciless game. You know what, fuck that F5. Quick save there. Simply because in case I feel I don't wanna have that little scene of, oh, we're reloading your energy. You're almost dead, but now you're alive. Happy now? Yeah, I don't wanna see that again, so. Okay. So yeah, the clock tower. Oh, Cornell! Out, demons of stupidity! The controls are still kind of a problem in this game. So I must say, after seeing Castlevania 64 in action, these controls are more responsive and I'd like that. Hey, so, okay, that's the trick there. Cornell! Your controls are not responsive. You almost have to do everything consecutively to make it work. Okay, got that. Got that. And now what? Oh. Okay, that. Gun jump! There! Oh, so basically that way I was going through originally was another way, another possible way. Clock tower is locked. So wait, are you telling me I have to go down here? I have to pick up that, don't I? One of the keys down here and one of this. Yeah, it was. Knew it. I'm gonna make a pretty short video today because I have a feeling the clock tower is gonna be long. And I'm not kidding when I say that I feel it's gonna be long. I have the feeling that this is gonna be something that will take me a few videos at least. Because the clock tower tends to be quite difficult and this game has been pretty insane in terms of difficulty, so I'm not expecting as much of getting lost as in the villa as dying over and over again. Okay, there's the key. That's comparatively easy. Clock Tower B, key has been used, okay. Or maybe this is gonna be another short level, like some of the previous ones, where I thought they were gonna be long, but I took a short, comparatively short time, as compared to what I expected. They ended up not being that challenging. Okay. So long as I get my fight with death, I'm satisfied personally. Okay, so this rotates. This kind of reminds me of something from Mario Sunshine, I think. Yeah, this kind of makes me think Mario Sunshine. Okay, so we don't want to go there. However, we want to jump there. Just missed it. And that would lead me to the Tetris blocks. L block. Okay, I need to get the Tetris blocks. Game, guide me to the Tetris blocks. Or maybe not. Oh, there is another one up there. Okay. You see, trying to be clever, aren't you? There's another save. Okay, so the game's trying to be clever here. But it won't beat me like that. Because I was ready for its cleverness. For I am the great Gee. Wow, okay, that was crazy, Cornell, that was crazy. Oh hey, we're going through the upper route. Rot. This place will rot. How can a clock tower rot anyway? Okay, so I'm gonna jump down there. Because I have the feeling that this is a good idea. Oh ho ho! Yeah, my keen instincts have guided me to be able to do that. Now tell me, have I done something stupid, or am I back somewhere where I was before? Let's see. Yeah, I'm back somewhere where I was before. Holy crap! Don't breathe on my face like that! You feel a little stupid for doing that, but I have the key! So... back to going down, down, down. Okay. Haha! Yeah, is the game trying to be clever right now? But I'm managing to show it that I am the boss. My keen instincts guide me through the Mario Bros. Platforms. Oh. Gotta get there! Yes! Success! A new record! Okay, there's that. So jump! Get it. Yeah, I'm actually doing awesomely today. Awesome sauce. Okay, need to stay in the one behind. Need to go back here. I'm liking this level. It's 3D platforming, which has tended to suck in this game. But in last few levels, like the Tower of Sorcery in this one, it's just been done right. I mean, it's fun. Honestly, that was that way too much to ask? Fun 3D platforming, which actually worked. I mean, the controls suck still. I mean, the controls won't stop sucking, but the game's getting the level design right. The 3D platforming is being used cleverly, and the elements it uses aren't a waste. Oh, I could have gone also over there, but I felt like going here was a better idea. Of course, why not? Let's go here. And it's another key. Because why not? Okay, gimme. No! Fuck. I'll get to the next room and I'll finish the video there, because, or maybe not, we'll see, because I'm feeling these climbs are just taking way too long. Because really, this spins way too slowly and it takes forever to finish the level, I'm sure. I'm sure you guys will get bored of seeing this. Don't blame ya. This is pretty boring. Yes, okay, that worked. This worked. Stuff's working for me today. Okay, need to wait until they meet again. So, yeah, once I get up there, it's save state, because I don't want to repeat this. It is the Tower of Science and the other tower. I mean, but especially for one thing, I haven't seen that many bottomless pits. Really, that's one thing this game's at fault, as many other platformers. Quick save. But yeah, bottomless pits suck. Game designers who have left them behind, they praise you for that. You have realized that bottomless pits fucking sucked. Hey, oh. Oh no! Ada! Ada, save! Yes! Oh, Canel, the village has burned all the people. It's all right now. No, it's not! Ah! Ada!
Cornel, help me!
I have hunted at least the thing the sacrifice was hidden here. Searching for the divine sacrifice almost upset the timing of the ritual. But I thought that stupid Licanthrope would prove to be a little useful. What fool is obeying the orders of the Count and wasting his own life?
We need to rescue Ada!
Don't go!
No, Ada, hang on! I'll save you, I promise! Okay. Blah blah blah. So, Ada's still alive! And you are gonna fuck shit up, Cornel. Show them the power of the 90s. Show them that you're no joke. And one thing that I remember from Castlevania 64, from our friend the merchant demon Renan. If you buy too much from Renan, he ends up fighting you by the end. I don't know if it stands true for this game as well. If it does, then I don't think I have bought enough from him, but I'm gonna try not buying more from him. Because if I buy any more and I end up unleashing his rage again, like in Castlevania 64, where when I remember I did that long ago when I played Castlevania 64, yeah, I don't want him to be wanting to make me pay my debts. Oh! Hey, this is actually clever. I like this! Yeah, I remember playing Castlevania 64 quite a while ago. I mean, many years ago, so don't expect me to remember that much. But yeah. Okay, finally! He didn't want to open the door. Cornel, why? Then I have the feeling that this level is about halfway through or so. Why do you have the horrible feeling of that? Well, clock towers tend to be not so nice to you. And I wouldn't expect unless from a clock tower in this game. Okay, I don't know where to go from here. And I don't think I want to stay here playing this here for the. Okay, I want to go there. Yeah, okay. So the next save point I find is where I'm finishing this video. There's a save point, okay. So when I get to that save point, I'm saving, and that's gonna be that for this video. If I can reach it. Okay, first, wait until I let that throws its stuff. Stop. Okay. That was stupid. But I have the idea now, so. Now what? I saved there before, so I can just restart by this room. So yeah, next time in Let's Play Castlevania Legacy of Darkness. I begin from here and I start saying what the fuck am I supposed to do. I'll see you next time.